Diane Stanley decided to write a book about me. I was born on April 15th, 1452, on a Saturday, at the third hour of the night, during the Renaissance area in Florida. I was living with my mother at first, but when she married a man of her class, I moved to her father. When I was 5, I was already living with my grandfather. I found a great friend who was my young uncle, full name Francesco, and explored the countryside. I then became fascinated with nature. I barely had any formal schooling because I was not born to married parents who were married, so I wasn't allowed to go to the university and be taught things like Latin and geometry. I had to think of something else I could do for a profession, and I did have to come out. My father took me to work with the famous artist, Andrea della Verrocchio. I soon became fascinated with art. My other interest was music, but I didn't really plan to be a musician. My accomplishments were mostly in my notebooks, which were filled with my plans for adventures, such as helicopters, cars, and even electricity. I also had future plans for paintings, amazing sights, breakouts, and observations for nature. When I was 20, I was accepted into the Painters Guild. I had many famous paintings, such as the Adoration of the Magi, and of course, the very famous Mona Lisa. Famous because it was the sole painting and shows movement in the art world, which was a completely new concept. I invented the underwater diving department, automatic paper feeder for a printing press, a machine to make metal screws, one of the world's first air cooling system, a door that closed automatically, a post-holder, ski-like shoes for walking on water, an automatic roasting spit, a clock measured minutes as well as hours, earth-moving machines, submarine, and many other things. My most famous invention is probably my flying machine. The king of France, Francis I,